hundreds of millions of the followers of Muhammad who have read his Quran would have of course come upon the name Israel not as the name of an individual but as the name of the tribes of Israel, Bani Israel. Not a single one of these hundreds of millions of Muhammadans would have known the root of the name if they had not read the Bible. The Bible tells us that the name Israel was actually a title given to Jacob, the son of Isaac, after he had struggled in a nocturnal fight with the angel of God. It is made up of two Hebrew words, Israel, meaning the fighter with the angel of God. Genesis 32.28. And he said to him, What is your name? And he said, Jacob. And he said, Your name shall be called no more Jacob, but Israel. For as a prince you have power with God and with men, and you have prevailed. From then on, according to the Bible, all the descendants of Jacob, the 12 tribes and their progeny, were identified as the people Israel, Am Yisrael, or Israelite. The Quran, based upon Muhammad's usual misunderstanding of the Hebrew language and traditions, created a separating barrier between the Israelites up to the death of Moses from those who followed his death, including the Jews. As far as he was concerned, the later followers of Moses, like the later followers of Jesus, were not the same as the earlier ones, since they allegedly disobeyed and broke their covenants with Allah, notwithstanding the fact that neither the Jews nor the Christians knew who Allah was beyond the Arabian Peninsula. Adding insult to injury, while the Hebrews, Israelites, and the Jews kept their monotheism intact against all odds for 2,500 years, Muhammad and his Arabs, who are supposed to be descendants of Ishmael, must have suffered an unusual case of total national amnesia for the same 2,500 years, having completely forgotten not only the names of Abraham and Ishmael, but also their covenant with Allah by turning idolaters. It was because of his contacts with and learning from the Judaized and Christian Arabs of the peninsula that Muhammad concocted a worthy ancestry for the Arabs and of course for himself by alleging that they are related to the Hebrew patriarchs Abraham and Ishmael. Even now at the present time, after an elapsed time of 1,400 years, 99.99% of the followers of Muhammad still do not know these facts. Ladies and gentlemen, as we both have found out from bitter experiences while debating with the Muhammadans, we should not be at all surprised, since in fact and reality, their ignorance of the Bible is matched only by their astounding and abysmal ignorance of their own Quran and Hadiths. That is why, even when we quote chapter and verse from their Quran and Hadiths, they angrily and ferociously accuse us of lying without once pointing out as to where, when, and how. Moreover, there are numerous verses in Muhammad's Quran, especially from the Mecca period, when Muhammad was not yet the leader of the first organized crime syndicate in history, incessantly complimenting the people of the book and using the Torah, Hebrew Bible, and New Testament as witnesses to the veracity of his alleged revelations. Nonetheless, all these earlier conciliatory verses were abrogated and overturned after he scurried away from his Quraysh tribe to Medina. This second period of alleged revelation is called the Medina period. These later hate-mongering, war-mongering, and virulently racist verses fill his Quran with anti-Jewish, anti-Christian, and anti-unbelievers diatribe. The reason for his incredible bitterness, malice, and hostility, especially towards the people of the book, is simple. Muhammad hated the Jews or Judaized Arabs because they were ridiculing his twisted, perverted, and contorted version of their biblical stories and character. They were proving him wrong to his believers, thus undermining his authority and pretensions to being a prophet of Allah by challenging the veracity of his revelations. His hatred for the Christians was more to do with his understanding that they associate Jesus and Mary as intercessors or even part of Allah's family, rendering them kuffar, the ultimate blasphemy. Al-A'raf 7.137. And we made a people considered weak and of no account, inheritors of lands in both east and west lands, whereon we sent down our blessings. The fair promise of the Lord was fulfilled for the children of Israel because they had patience and constancy. And we leveled to the ground the great works and fine buildings which Pharaoh and his people erected with such pride. We took the children of Israel with safety across the sea. Yunus 10.93. We settled the children of Israel in a beautiful dwelling place and provided for them sustenance of the best. It was after knowledge had been granted to them that they fell into schisms. Verily, Allah will judge between them as to the schisms amongst them on the day of judgment. Allah, in very clear Arabic, asserts that He fulfilled His promise to reward the people of Israel with the promised land, the same that the later conquering Arabs claim as exclusively theirs, contrary to the Quran. Taha 20.45. They, Moses and Aaron, said, Our Lord, we fear lest He hasten with insolence against us, or lest He transgress all bounds. He said, Fear not, for I am with you. I hear and see everything. So go ye both to Him and say, Verily, we are apostles sent by thy Lord. Send forth therefore the children of Israel with us, and afflict them not. With a sign indeed have we come from thy Lord, and peace to all who follow guidance. Al-Ma'idah 5.72. They do blaspheme who say, Allah is Christ, the son of Mary. But said Christ, O children of Israel, worship Allah my Lord and your Lord. Whoever joins other gods with Allah, Allah will forbid him. The garden and the fire will be his abode. There will, for the wrongdoers, be no one to help. If thou wert in doubt as to what we have revealed unto thee, then ask those who have been reading the book from before thee. The truth hath indeed come to thee from thy Lord. So be in no wise of those in doubt. Allah is instructing the followers of Muhammad that if they are in doubt about the veracity of what Muhammad is allegedly revealing to them, then they should ask the people of the book to whom Allah had previously revealed the Bible and Gospels. This singular verse destroys and negates all the lies and deceptions of the later followers of Muhammad regarding the authenticity and divine origin of the Bible, since had it been altered or tampered with by the Jews or Christians, Allah would not have used it as a witness to the veracity of the Quran. As we have mentioned on several occasions before, and I repeat this once again for effect, it is by divine will, qidra ilahiya, and divine justice, haqq ilahi, that the very Arabic verses of the Quran and Hadith that explain to the followers of Muhammad their cult belief system are the very same that completely and utterly discredit Muhammad's claims for prophethood, the alleged divine origin of his Quran, and their allegations that the Bible had been perverted by the people of the book. Al-Baqarah 2.83. And remember, we took a covenant from the children of Israel, worship none but Allah, treat with kindness your parents and kindred and orphans and those in need, speak fair to the people, be steadfast in prayer, and practice regular charity. Then did ye turn back, except a few among you, and ye backslide even now. Al-Baqarah 2.211, ask the children of Israel how many clear signs we have sent them. But if anyone after Allah's favor has come to him, substitutes something else, Allah is strict in punishment. Sahih al-Bukhari 1.828, narrated by Aisha. Had Allah's apostle known what the women were doing, he would have forbidden them from going to the mosque, as the women of Bani Israel had been forbidden. The women of Bani Israel are not forbidden from attending prayers in the synagogue, but are separated from the men. Sahih al-Bukhari hadith 2.574b, narrated by Abu Huraira. The Prophet said, A man from Bani Israel asked someone from Bani Israel to give him a loan of 1,000 dinars, and the latter gave it to him. The debtor went on a voyage. When the time for the payment of the debt became due, but he did not find a boat, so he took a piece of wood and bored it and put 1,000 dinars in it and threw it into the sea. The creditor went out and took the piece of wood to his family to be used as firewood. And the Prophet added, when he sowed the wood, he found his money. This is not only a miracle, but the ultimate compliment to the honesty of the Jewish borrower. Sahih al-Bukhari 5.279, narrated by Ibn Abbas. When the Prophet arrived at Medina, he found that the Jews observed fast on the day of Ashura. They were asked the reason for the fast. They replied, This is the day where Allah caused Moses and the children of Israel to have a victory over Pharaoh, so we fast on this day as a sign of glorifying it. Allah's apostle said, We are closer to Moses than you. Then he ordered that fasting on this day should be observed. By what stretch of logic or imagination could Muhammad and his pagan Arabs be considered nearer to Moses than the Israelites and the Jews? As usual with Muhammad, the consummate pirate of the desert, he not only plundered, pirated, plagiarized, and perverted the beliefs of the people of the book, he also hijacked their prophets as his own. His modern followers are continuing the same depredations.